We're just a week away from St. Paddy's Day and getting in the mood for all things Irish.
LCTV's own Dubuquer in Dublin, Allison Wong, joins us to share her Irish adventures in part one of her travel series.
Thanks, Caroline and Dimitri. I'm here on Grafton Street, one of the busiest shopping areas in Dublin. It's from this street that you can make your way into City Center and see some of the best landmarks that Dublin has to offer. So, let's get started.
To start off the tour, we head to the heart of Dublin. Here you'll find historic landmarks Dublin Castle and Christ Church Cathedral. Built in 1030 by King Sitrick, Christ Church has been a center point in Dublin for many centuries. It started out as a Catholic church, but was made Anglican by King Henry VIII in the 16th century. Many relics remain in the church today, including St. Lawrence O'Toole's heart. Today, you can admire the cathedral from outside for free. Getting inside will cost you €6. If you want to see one of the only remaining structures of medieval Dublin, walk down to Dublin Castle. The southeast tower was once used by the Anglo-Normans as a high-security prison. Today, the castle functions as a diplomatic center for Irish politics. Where the beautiful green gardens are now, there used to be a black pool. In fact, it was from this pool that Dublin got its name. If you're tired of all the hustle and bustle of City Center, finish your day off at St. Stephen's Green Park. Tucked away at the top of Grafton Street, the 22-acre park is a breath of fresh air. Go for a walk, have a picnic, or feed the birds. Whatever you do, you'd never know that you're right next to the busiest streets of Dublin. In Dublin, with photographer Charlie Grant, I'm Allison Wong, LCTV News.
Hey guys, I'm here on the River Liffey on this gorgeous spring day, ready to show you some more spots in Dublin. I think we have something for everyone in this one, so let's get started.
To take advantage of the spring weather, spend an afternoon in Phoenix Park. At over 1,700 acres, this is one of the largest walled city parks in Europe. You could spend hours here, but make sure you stop at two places. First, the Wellington Monument. It makes quite the impression at just over 200 feet tall. It was built to commemorate the victories of the Duke of Wellington, who was born in Dublin. The second must-see in the park is the Dublin Zoo. It's the largest zoo in Ireland and one of Dublin's most popular attractions. With a wide range of animals on display, from piglets to elephants, there's definitely something for everyone to enjoy. If you're looking for that big city feel, then hop on a bus and stop at O'Connell Street. This is truly one of the busiest streets in Dublin at over 1,600 feet long and 160 feet wide. And check out the famous monuments, the Spire of Dublin and the Statue of James Larkin, to name a few. As the sun starts to set, head over to the famous Temple Bar area. With old brick buildings, cobbled stone streets, and plenty of pubs, it's the perfect place to enjoy a pint of Guinness or two. In Dublin, with photographer Charlie Grant, I'm Allison Wong, LCTV News.
Well, after taking you guys to my favorite spots in Dublin, I decided to show you around the countryside. Come with me to the Rock of Cashel and the Blarney Castle.
Just over 100 miles from Dublin is the Rock of Cashel in County Tipperary. Long before the Norman invasion, this iconic site was home to royalty.
It's the ancient seat of power of the kings of Munster, and that dates back from at least 1,500 years ago.
The complex held little religious significance until one of Ireland's most famous saints came along.
It was the first site where St. Patrick baptized the first Irish king.
Although it's been occupied since the 4th century, the buildings we see today are from the 12th century. After taking in the ruins, don't forget to look out onto the landscape. Even when the sun isn't shining, it's breathtaking. 60 more miles south will take you to Blarney Castle, home of the famous Blarney Stone. People come from all over to kiss this stone in hopes that they will be bestowed with the gift of the gab.
The gift of the gab is kind of the gift of eloquence. It's the gift to be able to kind of wit about, be able to insult people without vexing them, be able to flatter them and get what you want, basically be able to get away in life with anything you want through the power of words.
Of course, I had to try it out for myself. Warning, it's quite the stretch.
So far back.
And how did the stone get to where it is today?
In the 1300s, McCarthy helped Robert the Bruce, who was a Scottish king. He sent 5,000 troops over to help him in the battle against the English. And as a thank you to McCarthy, Robert the Bruce sent the stone over.
Keep in mind, there's so much more to see at Blarney than just the stone. Be sure to check out the Poison Garden, which grows a wide variety of toxic plants. The more dangerous plants are caged for your safety. Most importantly, take time to take in all the natural beauty that Blarney has to offer.
And that wraps up my Irish adventures. I'll see you guys in Dubuque in 5 days. Caroline and Dimitri, back to you.